Jonathan, you've said in the past more than once that messages can't be avoided in music. What do you mean by that?
Well, I think some composers in some fashions are rather against music being anecdotal or saying anything too far outside music. But even the most abstract music has a speed, has a relation to our heartbeat, to our breathing, to our body, dance movements or gestures. So you can't avoid it, no. And the message is usually something to do with human emotion and human motion. So if you can't avoid them, why not enjoy them? And for me, music has always been very closely connected with life, emotions and experiences and memories, this great ragbag of things we all hold inside us, which we can recall with music, sometimes completely out of the forgotten arena.
There are clear messages all over your house for those who have eyes to see them of consuming interests of yours. There are pieces of Buddhist statuary, and on the wall opposite me here is a wonderful familiar picture by Fra Angelico of hosts of angels, adoring angels. And it seems rather appropriate that, having begun with angels this week, we end with them again in almost inconceivable numbers, in a piece which you've actually called Messages.
The text of the piece does not give any message, just the names of angels, enumerated and sung, of course. This could be seen as an invocation of the human act of worship, or I also like to think it's like one of these great Fra Angelico angel choirs with their Renaissance and Baroque instruments, which you also hear in the orchestration. I imagined that certainly when I was composing it. These great choirs arrange themselves in nine hierarchies, as is well known, and in seven heavens. And we know from the various ancient Jewish writings which one belongs where. And so it's quite possible to compose a text of these angel names, placing them where they traditionally belong, and to have the sense of a journey actually towards the ninth heaven from the first heaven. It's certainly one of the most inspiring subjects I've ever tried to treat.
As the piece moves on, there's a fantastic sense of something wonderfully kind of organic, of a kind of breathing of the cosmos, almost.
Yes, yes. That is very true. I took two very simple diatonic chords and made them an in-breath and an out-breath. And the breathing is actually very much slower than we would do normally. Maybe in deep sleep we breathe as slowly as that. But it does give a great sense of tranquility. The chords are simply E-flat and D-flat. And those are varied and transposed, of course, until they become very high and more complex. But throughout the work, this descending tone is almost constant.
Jonathan Harvey, thank you very much indeed for talking to me all week.
Great pleasure.
Let's now hear Messages in a performance given by the Berlin Radio Choir and the Berlin Philharmonic Orchestra, conducted by Reinbert DeLeu. Messages by Jonathan Harvey. The angelic voices we heard performing that litany of angels' names belonged to the Berlin Radio Choir, chief conductor Simon Halsey, and we also heard the Berlin Philharmonic Orchestra, conducted by Reinbert de Leeuw. We're very grateful to the Berlin Philharmonic Orchestra and Deutschland Radio Berlin for allowing us to broadcast that recording of the premiere of Messages in the Berlin Philharmonie in March 2008.